our final topic of the day. Mike Hyde picked off Tom Brady for the quarterback's first interception of the season. And after the game, Bill Belichick chased down Hyde to ask him about the play. Hyde said Brady was staring down Julian Edelman in the end zone when he made the pick. So, Shannon, what do you make of this?
Coach Belichick, Skip, information falls into two categories, gathering and distributing.
Okay.
Coach Belichick is always gathering information. You're always judging. When you step on the field, practice field, Skip, you, especially the game field, you're being judged by two different teams, your team and the opposing team. Mm-hmm. Coach Belichick is gathering information so he can tell Tom, now, Tom, next time if you look at this guy, you go backside. That's what he's doing.
Okay.
But he also can be, Tom's getting away. He's staring down receivers now, and I don't know. Huh. Mr. Kraft, we might be time for us to move on. But he's just gathering information.
You ever seen a head coach walk up behind an opposing player walking off the field and ask him, did you make that pick?
Right.
Well, didn't Belichick see it was Mike Hyde who intercepted to start with?
Right.
And then it seemed like they had some relationship,
right.
like they knew each other, but I don't know what their relationship is because he spoke to him like they had some sort of connection, right? Mm-hmm. Oh, he's staring down his receiver.
Right.
Well, obviously Brady bolted the pocket and he's on the run.
Right.
How many times does he do that?
And you know, a guy like Brady is not going to throw clearly back across his body. So there's only where he's going right there. Or right.
Yeah, and Mike Hyde made a really good play.
He
came off his man, and he dived
that
and he got
good one. Yesterday, California Governor Gavin Newsom signed the Fair Pay to Play Act with LeBron on his HBO show, Uninterrupted, The Shop. The bill will allow collegiate athletes in California to earn money from their likeness and image, but not directly from schools themselves. So, Snoop, how much impact will this have, in your opinion?
I think it'll have a lot of impact, and it's so overdue, and I'm so happy for people like LeBron James and his team for bringing this to attention, because the NCAA has been playing games for too many years. They've been robbing the kids. They've been cheating them. They've been selling their jerseys. They've been stealing their likeness and feeding them muscle milk and peanut butter sandwiches. And I know this for a fact because I got 5-star kids that went to college programs, and this is what they was dealing with. And I would try to give them money to get food. Nah, coach, you can't. I don't want to be in violation. I try to get them clothes. Nah, coach, you can't because I'm being in violation. I never understood why I couldn't do anything to help the kids out, and they mama's sitting at home struggling in a one-bedroom apartment, can't come to the games, can't barely see the games, can't even eat, and the kids' jerseys are selling like crazy. So this is a great step. I'm happy that California's the first one to do it, because I'm finna go spread the gospel. I'm finna go and get some of this licensing endorsement deals with some of these kids. So all you kids that need to get your money right, holler at Coach Snoop so I can help you get paid. You understand what I'm saying? 2023, that is, though.
So you have kids at USC and UCLA, and you will advise them to do what?
I would advise them to, first of all, take up a business class.
Yep.
To understand what business is and finances, because now you're going to start making finances and then take on different classes and courses that can help you position yourself for endorsements, for sponsorship deals. You may become an agent. You never know, but it's things that you can take in school to better yourself, to prepare yourself for that, and now you'll be paid for it as opposed to them being paid off of you. Like when they sign a big deal with Nike, Adidas, the school gets hundreds and hundreds of millions. Athletes gets no money, but his jersey sells. May not have his name on the back, but you know who that jersey belongs to because that number is connected to this athlete. So he should be paid off of that.
You're right. It's long overdue. I would never minimize the value of an education because it's been proven.
Sure.
the people with college degrees make more than people without. But as a former athlete going, a 4-year education doesn't do my grandmother any good if she can't pay the phone bill or the light bill. I remember my sophomore year calling home a collect call, and the operator collect call from Shannon to Mary Porter. Will you accept? My grandmother says no, because I can't pay this $50 phone bill I got now, and hung the phone up.
Yeah.
Well, what good is a 4-year education going to do me if my grandma can't pay the bill?
Mm.
What good is education we can't eat, Skip? Mm. That doesn't do me any good now.
No, right.
Okay. Yeah. My name is not on the back of the jersey in Savannah State. That's a different situation, but we know who number 13 is in Alabama.
Right.
Tua might not be on the back. Tagovailoa might not be on the back of that jersey.
But
we know who number 13 is.
Mm-hmm.
The same thing in Oklahoma. We know who number one represents.
They know.
It is.
Yep.
So give them an opportunity, the image and likeness. Well, you will get a great education, but what happens if I get hurt and then that scholarship is gone?
Mm-hmm.
Then what?
Yep.
If I ain't got no money to pay my light bill or my phone bill, my mom damn sure ain't got no money to pay for no $50,000 a year education.
But I got some players that graduated with a college degree and can't get a job.
Hmm.
So a college degree don't guarantee you a job.
Exactly.
And they were five-star athletes. They jersey sold like crazy. They were the talk of the town. And the university don't even let them on campus now. So it's just that I have a certain feeling towards the NCAA because I don't know who they are.
Right.
It's a hidden hand.
Do any of those kids get hurt?
No.
Like wreck their career, their NFL career or their NBA career?
No, they probably did some things that they should have did in the NFL. Right. But as far as like physically, no, they didn't. But as far as financially preparing themselves, if there would have been something like this in place to where they could have made money while they were jerseys were selling like crazy. Mm-hmm. And then there's some kids that when they leave the university, they still can go back and sell their jersey. It doesn't have the school logo, but it's the same color scheme, same number. It's my jersey. Now I can make money off
of
it.
Good point. Right. Yeah. Look, I've had my issues occasionally with LeBron on the court, but off the court, he has revolutionized the way athletes do business and create impact socially and financially.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing like him. He has changed the athletic world.
Yes.
In good way, all good ways, all positive, forward-thinking, eye-opening ways. He's changed athletic life for a lot of these kids.
Yes.
And I applaud him for getting behind this.
Definitely.
Gavin Newsom getting behind this. But it started with that guy on that show.
Skip, you see the platform. You see he started Uninterrupted.
Yeah.
And you see Kevin Durant got Boardroom.
Right. Yep.
You see he started a production company. Steph Curry has a production company.
Right.
You see LeBron James when he leaves the Cleveland and goes to Miami. He was the first not the first, Shaq left. Mm-hmm. But in the free agency as we know it now, the first guy says, you know what? I ain't got to be loyal to the soil.
Mm-mm.
I'm going to move. This notion that, oh, you can't move. I mean, Larry never left.
Right.
Magic never left.
Right.
Michael would have never left.
Right.
Bron said, bull jive. And once Bron broke free.
He broke free.
KD.
Yep. I want to go where I want to go. Not like Kawhi. Y'all not going to send me to a country and think I ain't going to win. Then I'm going to backslap y'all with this championship and shake, rattle, and roll on the way out.
Right.
He did.
So he's given, especially in basketball, because obviously football is unlike that, because you ain't nobody
getting
out.
It's coming, though.
We'll see what they do in the CBA in 2021.
Because I'm watching the move now. Like, players say, I want to be here. They making a minor adjustment.
They're trying. Mm-hmm. They're trying. But basketball is different because it's a superstar-driven league.
Right.
The NFL is different. It's a team league. It's the uniform.
Right.
It's the star on that. It ain't no player in that uniform. Mm-hmm. Dak can be Dak all he wants.
He ain't bigger than that star.
He ain't bigger than the star, Skip.
No.
Yeah. No matter who comes in, he ain't bigger than that black and gold in Pittsburgh.
No.
And that's the difference.
Right.
But LeBron James has been unbelievable.
He has. And I also want to applaud his man, Maverick Carter, because he's a visionary.
Yes.
And we talked earlier about AB surrounding yourself with the wrong people.
Great people.
LeBron, all great. All studs in their own way.
Yes.
All forward thinkers, great thinkers. And LeBron got all the right advice from the people he trusted from home.
But LeBron empowered them.
Yes,
I say,
he did.
Here, figure out your lane, be great at it, mm-hmm. and once you do, that's your job and your lane.
Exactly.
He didn't give them nothing.
He didn't give them nothing. Wow. He's like, hey, I trust you guys, but you're going to have to earn your keep.
Yes.
He gave him an opportunity.
Yeah.
And they Maverick went
says,
to work.
Maverick says, okay,
Maverick,
I'm over here.
Rich Paul, they went
Rich
to work.
Rich says, okay, Maverick, I'm over
on,
here.
Man.
Randy says, okay, this is my lane.
Shh. Man, to me, Magic Johnson personified business outside of basketball.
He did. Yes.
Yep. LeBron James put business, intellect, thought, future, forward thinking, all of the above. He grabbed a baton from Magic Johnson and he running with it, and it's a beautiful thing.
The thing that he did is that he encompasses Jordan and Magic.
Yes, Lord.
Jordan was just the shoe.
Mm-hmm.
Magic was business.
Yes, sir.
LeBron says, I can do shoes, I can do business, and I can be Muhammad Ali and talk about social issues.
Talk about it.
He said, I can encapsulate it all.
Talk about it.
While still being great.
Come on now. You sound like you're preaching now, Shannon.
You
finna make me put something in your pot. Hold on now.
What you got about your boy?
Hold on. You're preaching now, Skip. Take that. Take that drip, baby. It matches your outfit. Put it on.
Please put it on.
Bang, look at him. Look at the dripper.
Look at the dripper.
Oh.
Lord
have mercy. Every day. I'll steal some of Shannon.
Yeah, yeah. It's come on now. You know we got some.
We got the five here.
You like it?
The dripper.
I mean,
look at the dripper.
Do I like it?
I'm dripping over here.
I can't even. Shannon.
What do we
you don't
got?
Have to share to the world.
Oh, you restocked now.
That L.A. Kush, because, you know, the Lakers going back to that thing, man.
Mm. We got the pounds over here.
Mm. Look at me, LBS.
No. So is this going to be a part of the Friday?
That's that drip, boy.
Mine.
You sure?
Just mine.
Yeah. I tell you, drip, you. This is ensemble,
it,
man.
They said this bubblegum cookie, but this
that Laker, man.
Yeah. You better not chew on there too long.
Yeah.
Oh.
Snoop. We do appreciate it.
And I love this show, man. This is one of my favorite shows to watch every morning. I love being a part of it. I don't mind getting up to be on it. Anytime y'all need me to come talk some sports talk, when my team is winning, losing, or if we're drawing, it don't matter. I'm here for y'all.
Well, a lot of times I need you to sit over there.
Snoop, thank
good
you.
Good looking. Thank
you for give the trip, Bayless. You just made his day.
Drip,
day in Undisputed History.
Hey, he didn't drop a drip or drip or drop. This is Drip Bayless, baby. Yeah. Pay attention.
All right, Snoop, you're welcome anytime.
All the time.
More the merrier. All right, we got to talk about Tom Brady. Yeah. Basically, he was thrown under the bus, and we'll tell you the full story. Thank you, Snoop.
Thank you all for having me.